In this video series, we'll be seeing how to set up the PI interface for universal file and stream loading, or PI UFL, from start to finish. Now, what is PI UFL? PI UFL is an interface that allows you to read data from really basic simple sources like text files and write it to the PI server. So data like this, with tag names, timestamps, and data, all the way to something maybe a little bit more complex, like this, maybe a lab analysis. We can read this data, parse it, and write it to the PI system. Now, PI UFL is an extremely flexible interface. It can read these, which are text files, and it can also read from POP3 mail servers and from serial cables and serial ports. So once you install the PI UFL interface, a whole set of examples will be available. You can find those if you go to Program Files, PIPC Interfaces, PI UFL, and Examples. We have a whole list of examples available to you. Like many PI interfaces, the PI UFL interface has flexibility as to where it's installed. It can be installed on the machine sharing the data files, so in the machine that actually has these data files written to them. It can be installed on a separate node, able to read the data files remotely and then write to the PI server, or it can be installed on the PI server itself. If installed else on another machine, buffering can be enabled. If writing to a PI high availability collective, which has multiple PI servers, PI SDK buffering must be enabled in order to send the data to both servers rather than just a single one. The basic steps of configuring a PI UFL interface will be to download and install the PI UFL interface, load it with this, the PI interface configuration utility, build a .ini file. Now this configuration file allows you to read the text file that you're reading from, what's the format, and then we'll be doing some work on the PI server itself to make sure that the security connection will allow us to come in and write data to a PI tag. So we see here a PI tag that has had data written to it. All this and more will be shown in this series from OSIsoft Learning.